We're here at the National Stadium today, where Gateshead host Dover Athletic in the Vanarama Conference. The Heat head into the clash without a winning four, and were unlucky last time out against Torquay, where a late equaliser condemned them to their seventh draw in 12 games. It is imperative that they get a win here to galvanise their promotion push.
Whereas Torquay were a League 2 side last season, Dover beat Kent rivals Ebbsfleet to gain promotion from the Conference South, and the Heat haven't played today's visitors since 1998. The Whites had a poor start to the season, but are unbeaten in their last five games and should prove tough competition for Gateshead this afternoon.
The visitors head into today's clash on the back of a 5-0 win over Nuneaton in midweek. And despite being 9 places above them in the league table, the Heat must ensure they shore up a defence which has conceded 6 goals in the last 3 games to get the win today.
A handful of Dover fans have made the 350-mile trip for today's match, but Gary Mills' side will hope to send them back to the White Cliffs empty-handed as they look to close an 11-point gap to leaders Barnet with 2 games in hand.
So let's see through the teams then. There's how the home line up this afternoon. The goal, row number 1, Adam Bartlett. 5, James Curtis. 6, the captain. 8, Phil Turnbull. 15, Tom Allen. 16, Craig Baxter. 19.
Number 15, Sean Francis. So, Chris, you must be delighted with another away victory.
Yeah. It took us a while to get into the league. Got a bit of a shock, really, the strength of it. Some great clubs in there, isn't there? But now, as I say, we've got a way in there. Got the players know what to do, and as you say, we're getting some good results.
You seem very organised defensively.
Yeah. I mean, in saying that, we've been scoring a few goals lately, wasn't it? 5 on Tuesday. Today we got 2 and had a few other chances. And against these, Gateshead, I mean, who are a great side, aren't they? I saw them in the playoff finals as well at the end of the season. They were lucky not to be playing in the league themselves. A great side, and unless you are against these, you struggle and they run you ragged. But, as I say, we did the jobs. Everybody didn't play great at times, but it's about results.
You seem to score a good time as well, didn't you?
Yeah, any time's a good time, but yeah, no, it did give them a bit of a knock, but they got back, didn't they, and 1-1, and as I say, it shows the character of the lads that they didn't feel sorry for themselves, and they came back, and as I say, we hit the bar straight afterwards, so, you know, it could have been 2-up, could have been 3-1 at one stage, couldn't we? Tuwu is quite upset with himself there, didn't make it, could have had a penalty, I thought, as well, so... Again, you know, against an exceptional side, we're pleased to get 3 points.
And good preparation for the FA Cup next week.
Yeah, well, as just said to the lads there, you know, we've got a game against Torquay on Tuesday. That is the immediate thing. You can't worry about next Sunday we're playing. We've just got to go and keep it going and try and focus for Tuesday.
Obviously, you're on a good run as well at the moment, aren't you? It's
an exceptional run, really. As I say, I don't know. We haven't lost in, I don't know.
I think it's 9, actually.
9, is it? Yeah, I've lost. Yeah, I mean, again, you just take it each game. But not many sides have scored against us, really, as well, lately at home. We've been immense, really. So, yeah, we're building a nice squad, and the lads want to compete in this level, and that's what it's about, really.
And it was almost the perfect away performance in many ways.
Yeah, I mean, as I say, you know, if you score 2 away from home, and as I say, against these are good. I mean, you know, they're one of the best, if not the best football. Well, they're definitely the best football inside, aren't they? Again, you know, with their chances, it might be different, but you just make the most of it.
Fantastic. Well played today.
Thanks very much.
Well done.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
Thanks for that.
So you seem to be in control of a large part of that game. So how disappointing was it that you end up on the losing side?
Disappointing, you know. And yeah, we started the game well. First half, I thought we played how we can play without finishing the chances off that we had. But again, we've conceded two sloppy goals that, in my opinion, are sloppy goals because they could have been avoided. And come out second half and looked a little bit lost. And so the fact that how we played second half disappointed me really today, that we didn't really show enough to get back into the game.
You were talking about sloppy goals there. I think that's 8 goals in 4 games you've conceded now. How do you plan on cutting that out for Alfreton on Tuesday?
Well, just defend better, simple as. You know, if the ball's wide, you've got to stop the ball coming in your box. You've got to stop crosses. If the cross does come in your box, we've got to defend it better. You know, we've got to be first to that ball. If you're centre half, you've got to head that ball away. Your positional place has got to be better. You can't allow a ball to come in the box and somebody get a free header. So stop the cross and defend it better if it comes in the box. I know it might sound simple, but that's how simple the game is.
Alfreton, obviously, on Tuesday. Is there any changes you plan on making, or is it just, as you say, cutting out those simple mistakes?
You know, I'm going to go to bed tonight, and then I'll wake up tomorrow and we go again. So I'll have a couple of days to think about what team's going to be played on Tuesday.
And obviously, looking forward to Sunday, wanting to tie in the FA Cup. Do you think that was any distraction to your players today?
No, not at all. Not at all. This is more important than the FA Cup. We've got another league game on Tuesday. That's so important to us on Tuesday away at Alfreton. So we'll go there, hopefully pick up a win, and then we'll worry about the FA Cup and you know, hopefully get a result in that next Sunday. So the league's more important to us at the moment because that's the next game, and then we'll take the next one after that.
Okay, cheers, Gary. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks. Cheers. Thank you.
So another disappointing result for Gateshead there, who dropped to 9th in the table and will need to quickly regain form if they are to match last year's playoff berth. They face a trip to 2nd from bottom Alfreton in midweek and will hope to re-kick their form from earlier in the season. This has been Jamie Goodenough and Sean McCormack reporting for the Press Box.